Trigonometry units section 2. We will work with angles ranging from 0 to 90 degrees, and every angle in that range has a unique ratio for each of the three trig functions that we will be working with. We can find those ratios or angles, depending which information is given, through a graphical approach, and we looked at that in the previous video. We also can refer to a table of values, or we can use a scientific calculator. And this is going to be our preferred method. The calculator can replace that table of values. And here the table is showing us that regardless of the size of the triangle, if we have an angle measuring 12 degrees, regardless, as I said, of the size of the triangle, that sine ratio and cosine and tangent ratios will always be the same. The calculator will give us that information and replaces the use of tables. First, though, we want to make sure that your calculator is set up for angles measured in degrees. We have other ways of measuring angles, but we will only be working with degrees here. One way is to look at the display. Some calculators will either put a D or a DEG in the display so that you can clearly see whether it's in a degree mode versus some other angle measurement use for angles. Other calculators, you may have to go into a menu to see whether it's calculating in degrees or not. So here we have our table, and if the question was what is the ratio for the sine of an angle in a right triangle having a measure of 35 degrees, we can look down until we get to 35 corresponding with the sine and answer our question. Using a calculator, different calculators operate in different manners. For calculators that are known as direct algebraic logic calculators, the first thing to do in place of using a trig table would be to press the sine key, type in the angle measurement, and then press your equals. The display should show the ratio and even with greater detail than what the table value had. So if we have a right triangle with an acute angle, the ratio of those two sides, and remember sine is defined as the opposite side over the hypotenuse, that ratio would reduce to a 0.574. If you have a traditional scientific calculator, you need to first enter the angle measurement and then press the sine key. That will cause the display to show the ratio that you're looking for. For additional practice, turn to pages 18 and 19 for these skills.